Solve the system of equations. Now I'm looking at these three equations, and what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to find a way to combine the equations and eliminate a variable. So I'm looking at equation 1 and 2, and notice that the y's, you have a plus y and a minus y. That means if I add the first equation and the second equation, that'll eliminate the y's. And here I'll just number this equation 3. So I'm going to add equations 1 and 2 first. So it's going to be negative 3x plus y plus z equals 1, and then 2x minus y plus 4z equals negative 11. Now adding, negative 3x plus 2x is negative x plus y, and then subtracting y, the y's go away or simplify out, and that's what you want. And then z plus 4z makes plus 5z. And then 1 plus negative 11, or subtracting 11, is negative 10. Okay, so this is our first equation for solving, and there's only two variables, x and z. So then what we want to do is we want to create another equation with only x and z, and then we'll have two equations like that, and we can solve for x, solve for z, and then eventually figure out y. Now I can't use equations 1 and 2 again, but I can use either 1 and 3 or 2 and 3. And it looks like either way, if I use equation 2, if I multiply through by 4, that will give me minus 4y and plus 4y, so let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to do 4 times equation 2 right here. So I'll do 4 times 2x, which is 8x, and then 4 times negative y, which is negative 4y, and then 4 times 4z, which is plus 16z, equals, and then 4 times negative 11 is negative 44. Have to make sure you multiply by the constant as well. And then equation 3, I'm just going to write that down here. Negative x plus 4y minus z equals 14. Now add. 8x minus x is 7x. Negative 4y plus 4y is 0y. And then 16z minus z is 15z. And that's positive, so I'll put a plus there. So negative 44 plus 14 is negative 30. So here are my two equations that have two variables in them. And I'm going to use those two equations to solve for x and for z. Now if I compare the x's, I notice if I multiply this first equation by 7 and then add, I would have negative 7x and then plus 7x, so the x's would eliminate. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do 7 times this equation here. So 7 times negative x is negative 7x. And then 7 times plus 5z is plus 35z. And then 7 times negative 10 is negative 70. And then down here we're going to have 7x plus 15z equals negative 30. Now I'm going to add. Negative 7x plus 7x is 0. 35z plus 15z is 50z, and negative 70 plus negative 30 is negative 100. Divide both sides by 50. We're going to get z equals negative 100 divided by 50, which is negative 2. Okay, so now we're going to start back substituting. And I'm going to back substitute into this equation here, just because the numbers are a little smaller. So I have negative x, and then plus, and then it's going to be 5 times negative 2 for that z value we found, equals negative 10. So negative x minus 10 equals negative 10. If I add 10 to both sides, negative x equals 0. So that means x has to equal 0. And I divided by negative 1 here, kind of mentally. Okay, so we have x and z now. We need to find y, and so I'm going to back substitute again into one of the three original equations. And I'll just use equation 1. So we have negative 3 times 0 plus y plus negative 2 equals 1. Now we'll simplify. Negative 3 times 0 is 0, so that can just go away. And then we'll have our y, and then plus negative 2 is just minus 2 equals 1. So y equals 3 by adding 2 to both sides. So now we have our answer. X is 0, y is 3, z is negative 2. That's our ordered triple. And what you can do is you can just mentally check in a couple different equations to make sure. So for this first equation, negative 3 times 0 is 0, and then so I would have 3, and then plus negative 2 equals 1. That's correct. Well, let's try the second equation. If I have 0 here, then I would have negative 3, and then minus 8, which is 4 times negative 2, equals negative 11. That works as well. And might as well check the third equation, 0. And then 4 times 3 is 12. And then minus negative 2 or plus 2 equals 14. That works. So we checked in all three equations. This is for sure the correct solution for the system of equations. And visually what that means, these are three different planes or flat surfaces. They all intersect at a common point, 0, 3, negative 2.